Shalom to the elect of Israel, to the holy elect of Israel, you Hebrew Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, West Indians, and Haitians. Gotta give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, the Most High, the Heavenly Father. His Hebrew name is Yahweh, not Yahweh, not Jehovah, not God, not Elohim, not Most High, not Lord, not Yah, not Jah, not Ahayah, not Allah. It's Yahweh. His only begotten son name in the Hebrew is Yahweh Shah. Not Yahshua, not Yeshua, not Jesus Christos, not Jesus Christ, not Serapis Christus, not Yeshaya, not Yehoshua. It's Yahweh Shah. So gotta give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Rekha Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well, who teach well. To all the apostles and elders over all of Israel, whether he accepted or not. And a sincere salutation to all the ark and pushing this truth and believing this truth. Throughout the four winds of the earth and the entire world, waking up the hopeful elect. And shalom to the akwath who are listening and learning. The few sisters who are listening and learning. Coming at you another lesson in truth, facts, faith, and edification. Another daily edification. Lord's willing, this be edifying. This is for educational purposes only. This is not for monetary gain. I do not own a copyright to this video. This is for educational purposes only. Lord's willing, this be edifying. I'm tying this lesson. Perfect example of a two-third woman falling and sitting on the ground. The Lord is making perfect examples of two-third women falling out of their place. As we always say, for the six-pack Joe Edomite, the Job 9 and 24s. How are you on the bottom in your kingdom? When you see a two-third, you look at them. I'm talking about women, because they have been following the ways of their father, the devil, a master, the Job 9 and 24s, since they have been given women's liberation, putting them in all high places, right? Putting them over the man. So how are you on the bottom in 2021, when you have been given all these options, right, to rule over the man? How are you on the bottom? The same line that we have for these six-pack Joe Edomites, we have it for you two-third women. How are you on the bottom following behind Master, since you have been given women's liberation? The Lord is showing perfect examples of you women, of you two-third women, falling and being on the bottom, and you shall be desolate. Lord, wouldn't this be edifying?
Hi, Kevin. Good evening. I know I look like a hard five right now.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Good. What do you got for me?
I want to start off, I really appreciate your podcast as well. I learned so much from you. And I love the tough love. I'm starting to think that maybe I shouldn't have, like, any expectations whatsoever. I'm, like, you know, listening to you, I'm starting to realize that I do have two children. My children are 12 and 14. Okay. And, you know, I really haven't really accomplished much. I'm 33. Should I expect anything? Or should I just...
What do you mean what do you do for a living?
I'm currently, like, unemployed. I haven't really had, like, a good career. I've held like little like cashier jobs here and there. I'm not really
looking for a business. Who do you live with?
I live with my mother.
And you asked me what you should expect in a man?
No, I'm just trying to think that I should probably have no expectations, right?
Of a man or a relationship?
Both? Don't they go hand in hand, coincide?
Well, they're different.
Okay.
Do you expect to get a relationship? And if so, then what kind of man?
Okay. So I guess that this is the things I don't have planned. I don't know.
How many fathers?
One father.
Where's he at?
He's not around. He's like, he had another child after me.
Okay, so I got it.
So, you see, that's a part of the curses, man. That's a part of the curses. Now, for the most part, you could say, okay, she don't have a bunch of kids. She didn't have 4, 5, 6 kids with 2, 3 baby daddies. She got 2 kids and 1 daddy. So you can't say she's out there in the world doing whatever. But we still under the curses. It's Deuteronomy 28 and 54. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil towards his brother and toward the wife of his bosom and toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave. This is a part of the curses. But you with all your bachelors and masters and associates, you should already know this. But they don't.
Ask, how do you get to be 33 with 2 kids and no job?
How? Well, I lose my mother, currently on unemployment.
Yeah, I think the answer is the first thing you need to do is, and I mean, no disrespect, you gotta get this adult thing together. You gotta be able to take care of yourself. Because your mother has already raised you, now she's raising you again with her grandkids.
Right.
No man worth his salt's gonna come in and deal with an unemployed woman with 2 kids.
Right.
So I don't know what you mean about having an expectation.
Well, okay, so
see, if you women will fall back in order, man, if you women will repent and fall back in order according to the ways of Yahweh, Baha Shem Yahweh Shah, you'll be okay. But we understand 2/3 have to feel that lot. And then you got those hopefully elect women, the women that the Lord already have predestinated to get salvation, they're going to be in order. But this is just showing. Now, she could repent. You know, she still could be saved. But this is just showing the perfect example of women that's going outside of their order, man. Your order is to be under your husband, to be under your man. If you don't have one, fall back, repent, and follow the ways of these men that's teaching the scriptures diligently, sincerely, through 100% truth, understanding of salvation, man. Let me tell you in Hebrews 6 and 9, things that accompany salvation. If you fall in line, fall back in order, you wouldn't go through this. But because of the pride of your heart, just like Esau Edom, you have been deceived.
So I haven't had expectations. So my mother said I've been doing is I've been dating the underdog.
Okay.
And which doesn't end well.
How old is your mother?
She's been dating the underdog.
54.
And where's her husband?
Oh, my dad passed.
How long ago?
When I was 14.
Okay, so it's been quite a while. Where's her boyfriend?
She hasn't, dated or anything. So you want to get her up?
No. I'm just saying your mom, bless her heart, really is not in a position to give you advice. See, what you're in is a position with a mother,
mm-hmm.
and you're now her relationship. So she has no problem with her grown daughter
mm-hmm.
and her grandchildren being in the house because she has no man.
Mm-hmm.
You aren't doing anything. You said you're on unemployment?
Mm-hmm.
When was the last time you had a boyfriend or anything like that?
Last year.
Okay. Which is, you don't really need one. You got to be able to take care of yourself. Mm-hmm. So expectations of a man, ma'am.
And if he ain't with you now, that means he just got the box and he dipped out, man. He just got the box and dipped out, man.
You're not taking care of yourself, much less your children, so you can't have expectations of a man.
Of anyone, right.
Mm-hmm. I mean, if your mother would have put you out.
Mm-hmm.
So when's the last time you held a job?
A year ago, I was cashier.
Okay. And was there an injury or something?
No. I was fired for being late.
So you're just lazy?
No. No. It was,
so you just trifling?
I was late. I was just
lazy. So you're trifling?
Maybe, yeah. Okay.
Are you trolling me?
No.
Let me see your hand. Put those up. Uh-oh, nice fingernails.
Thank
you. Did you do those yourself?
No.
You been got them done?
Mm-hmm.
Who paid for that?
Now, she could be a Northern Kingdom, but she could be a Judite as well. She look like she's Judite, but she could be Northern Kingdom. But more likely, she's just a light-skinned Judite.
I paid for them.
With what?
With the unemployment money.
Are you trolling me?
No, but Kevin, don't you think I have to look like something?
I think you need to grow up.
Oh, okay.
Ma'am, you're 33 years old and haven't had a job in a year. And the job you had as a cashier, you got fired from being late. Mm-hmm. That's lazy and that's trifling.
Hey, and that spiritual cut, hey, it's the signs of the time to come, man. It's the signs of the time of Jacob trouble. This is Isaiah 32 and verse 9. It reads, "Rise up, ye women that are at ease. Hear my voice, ye careless daughters. Give ear unto my speech." That's what you should be doing. Repenting, man. "Many days and years shall ye be troubled, ye careless women, for the vintage shall fail, the gathering shall not come." Vintage is your workplace, your job. It's going to fail. The gathering shall not come. Meaning your monies. Whether you're making $100,000 a year, whatever. Your vintage shall fail. The gathering shall not come. Section 8, HUD, Habitat Housing, Social Security Disability, your job, making every day, every week living, or every two weeks, however you get paid, all of it's going to be gone. This is the perfect example of a two-third woman not having nothing in Jacob's trouble, man. "Tremble, ye women that are at ease. Be troubled, you careless ones. Strip you and make you bare, and gird sackcloth upon your loins. They shall lament for the teats, for the pleasant fields, for the fruitful vines." You're going to lament for the things that you used to have because you're not going to have them anymore. This is the Lord showing perfect examples of two-third women having nothing and being on the bottom and being destroyed. Those righteous elect men are preserved. They being preserved, man. For those righteous women that's falling back in order, watching, listening, and preparing themselves, man.
If you were a man, they would call you a deadbeat. But the only reason you get away with this is because you got two kids and you get unemployment, so you juke the state.
Is she getting away with it because she a woman? That's why she's getting away with it. Jeremiah 31 and 22. "How long wilt thou go about, O thou backsliding daughter? For the Lord have created a new thing in the earth. A woman shall come past a man." You're supposed to be skyrocketing right now in your career. What are you doing? What is you doing? How are you on the bottom? This is the Lord showing spiritual movements, man. At least you repent, convert, and be healed, that your sins may be blotted out.
You got the nerve to have these fingernails up like you got money to pay for them. That's trash.
But don't you think that as a woman you should like look like something?
For who?
You know, just for like...
For your mom and your kids, you ain't going nowhere, you ain't doing nothing. This is the entitlement and delusion. The taxpayers are paying for this.
Well, your money goes for unemployment, but I see what you're saying.
But we came on saying having expectations, and I'm like, at what point do you plan on getting into life and start being an adult?
All right. I mean, I hope, yeah, you know, you're 100% right.
I know. And where'd you get the phone?
I bought it.
With whose money?
With my money.
Is it like prepaid service or something?
Yeah. I'm not.
Okay, ma'am. I think you know the answer, but no dating. That's not realistic. Mm-hmm. And there's no way a 33-year-old woman should, with two kids, should have enough pride to be going to get her nails done.
Hey, and we're here telling you what you should be doing, man. You know, because as we always say, it ain't about just tearing down, man. It's about tearing down and rebuilding, man. That's what Yahweh Shah was doing. When they was going off, when they thought they knew something, they knew nothing. Yahweh Shah was tearing them down and rebuilding them, man. That's why I tell you Romans 12 and 2, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And we're here telling you what you should be doing, that you should have a covering. But you don't want to do it. You're trying to go your way. Like I tell you in John 10, you're trying to find another way up. There's no way. There's no other way. It seems like it's good right now, right? You get a little money. You living good. You driving. You sliding. You know, you got a little bank account. You got a decent place to stay in. That's all going to fail, man. If you ain't returning back to Yahweh Shemaw Shai, you're going to lose. In the Lord is showing perfect examples of the two-thirds that's going to lose when jig of trouble take flight. We're telling you what to do. Repent. Get out of that prideful state, which is of the Job 9 and 24s. That's their lot.
I think you should know that, though.
But I feel like with some things, you should have to. A woman should be kept. It's like, you know.
For whom?
Huh?
For whom?
Just in general, like you said, like, you know, a lady should be a lady. I feel like, you know, it's one of the things that a woman should just, you know. I would have had my kids, but it's not. But a woman should just, you know, have like certain upkeep.
That you can't afford to pay for. Well, seriously, if you were in a country that didn't have such a welfare system. If we didn't have such a welfare system, you know, if you were in a country that did not where people, healthy, physically able women.
Well, no, I would have a job right now. It's just that, you know, because of like the pandemic hit, so I don't want to go.
Now, what state are you in?
New Jersey.
Right. When was the last time you applied for a job?
I was working last year.
When was the last time you applied for a job?
Last week. Last week I applied for front desk at a hotel.
And how many applications did you put in last week?
I only put in the one.
One whole application. When 140,000 women last month lost work, we put in one application. Well, guys, it's not uncommon. I wish I could say she was trolling, but I've seen this before. No, she's not lying. She's not lying. Trust me, she's not lying.
So, I just seen this, and I just want to get a few precepts. Hey, this is the Lord showing, hey, that power, man. That Isaiah 4:1, man. You got these righteous women that's turning back to Yahweh Shemaw Shah, man, and they falling back in order. But you just got two-thirds that just ain't gonna do it, man, because of the pride that they got from Esau, Edom. This is Isaiah chapter 3 and verse 12. It reads, as for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. O my people, they which lead thee call thee to err and destroy the way of thy paths. This is verse 16, Isaiah 3 and 16. Moreover, the Lord said, because the daughters of Zion are haughty and walk with stretched forth necks and wanton eyes, walking and mincing as they go and making a tinkling with their feet. Therefore the Lord will smite with a scab the crown of the head of the daughters of Zion, and the Lord will discover their secret parts. And you know what your secret parts is. In that day, the Lord Yahweh will take away the bravery of their tinkling ornaments and their feet and their calves, their tinkling ornaments about their feet and their calves and their round trials like the moon. The chains and the bracelets and the mufflers, the bonnets and the ornaments of the leg and the headbands and the tablets and the earrings, the rings and the nose jewelry, the changeable suits of apparel and the mantles and the wimplers and the crisping pins, the glasses and the fine linen and the hoods and the veils. And it shall come to pass that instead of a sweet smell, there shall be stink. And instead of a girdle, a rent. And instead of well-set hair, baldness. And instead of a stomacher, a girdle of sackcloth, and burning instead of beauty. Thy men shall fall by the sword, and thy mighty men in the war, and her gates shall lament and mourn, and she, being desolate, shall sit upon the ground. Going into Isaiah 4 and 1. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. This only applies to those righteous women. But the Lord say, the pride of your heart have deceived you, just like Esau Edom, so he's going to bring you low. That's why I tell you, matter of fact, Isaiah 32 and 2, and a man shall be as a hiding place from the wind, and a covert from the tempest, as the rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. Verse 3, and the eyes of them that see, which is going to be who? These women. And the eyes of them that see shall not be dim. they're going to see where their salvation lies at, man. They're going to see where their covering lies at. And the eyes of them that see shall not be dim, and the ears of them that hear shall hearken. This is talking about those women in that day that's going to run to that man for covering. And they're going to be in order. This is 1 Timothy 5 and 6. But you two-third women that don't want to fall in order, you will not get a covering from a righteous man in that day. You will not have that. 1 Timothy 5 and 6, but she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. And these things given choice that they may be blameless. We're supposed to be tearing down and rebuilding back up what? With the transforming and renewing of your mind, man. This is Micah, chapter 7 and 10. You just got those hard heads. You just got those knuckleheads. It's like you got two-third men, you got two-third women that will not. Why? Because they have their conscience here with a hot iron, man. You can't tell them nothing, man. Micah 7 and 10. Then she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which say unto me, where is the Lord Yahweh? Thy power. My eyes shall behold her. Now shall she be trodden down as Maya in the streets. Maya of the she shall be trodden down as Maya of the streets, man. This is the Lord showing. If you the women don't repent, you're going to be brought low. Just like your master. Lord, when it's edifying, got to give all praise and glory to Yahweh. Bahashim Yahweh Bahashim Rekah Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Red Millstone, who well, who teach well. And the sincere say, taste and talk to all can push this truth and believe in this truth. That the four ends of the earth, the entire world, waking up the whole elect. Shalom to the Akwath who are listening and learning. The few sisters who are listening and learning. Lord, what is edifying? Till next time I say, Shalom. Tawada for tuning in. May Yahweh Shemal Shah continue to bless you in your houses. Stay prayed up.